Yeah. Yeah. Travis, can you pronounce your name, spell it, and give us your title?
Yep. Sorry. My name is Travis Stewart. I'm Indiana Conservation Officer. Travis is T-R-A-V-I-S. Stewart is S-T-E-W-A-R-T.
Great. And I'm Patrick Myers, P-A-T-R-I-C-K, Myers, M-Y-E-R-S, and I'm the Deputy Fire Chief here at Lawrenceburg.
Great. Why don't we start with you, Travis? Can you give us an update?
Yep. So we were notified around 10:30, just after 10:30, of a individual that was struggling in the water. The report came from some witnesses that were up here on shore. Some assistance was provided, but the individual ultimately ended up going under the water, and then a search was conducted based off of witness statements. At this point, we can confirm that an individual has been located, but that's all the information we have on that part of it.
Is it a man, you can confirm?
We can confirm an individual has been located, yeah. The report was a male.
Any idea yet what kind of flotation device he was on or how he got to this area of the Ohio River?
We don't have any of that information at this point. At this point, like I said, the only thing that we know is that there was an individual that was in the Ohio River, but how he got there, we don't have that information at this point.
If he were on a flotation device, how could he go under?
So just because you have a flotation device, you know, a lot of it just boils down to, are you wearing it properly? Is it a flotation device that is appropriate for the size of person or individual you are? And, you know, because it could be one that's rated for an individual, you know, lesser weight than you, or it doesn't fit. So say if you need a small and you wear like a large, it could, you know, pop off or come off in that aspect of it. So the report was there was some type of flotation device, but we have not confirmed what that was.
So was he wearing it or on the flotation?
No, the report was that there was just flotation device around him in the water. Not wearing it, but it was around him.
Did you find it? Have you found one?
We have not found anything.
I have not located that.
Okay, so it wasn't like a log or something that he was
clinging to? It was not a log. It was just some type of flotation device is what they said. Whether it be a raft or a tube, we don't know.
A lot of snags in the river, huh?
There is a lot of debris, yeah.
What about, where would the investigation go from here to try and figure out how he got into the water? Could it have been someone, I know barges go through here all the time, that maybe just fell off the barge. They don't change shifts for every 6 to 8 hours or whatever it is.
Yeah, so at this point, you know, an autopsy will be conducted to figure out, you know, what the ultimate cause of death was, and then also figure out and identify who the individual was, and then just start backtracking and figuring out how he got in this location.
Has anyone from the area said they're missing someone, like as far as, is he local here?
We have not had a report of a missing individual.
Chief, can you talk a little bit more about the search itself and how you went about locating it? I know you were there, then you went downriver a little bit, you brought in extra resources, dive teams, kind of the resources, what you used, and how you ultimately found the
individual. And I'm so sorry, Chief, do you mind stepping just a little bit further forward? There you go, thank you.
So we used Water Rescue, Dearborn County Water Rescue, Lawrenceburg Fire Department dispatched their boats initially. Our boat, Lawrenceburg Fire Department boat, was on the water within 5 minutes, on the scene within 10. We used our side sonar scans to check the banks, to start checking and working our ways out. With the underload and the debris in the river, we got a lot of false readings. So we had to kind of get those false readings confirmed or denied. And then ultimately, as they moved their way back up to where he was initially sighted, a little farther out in the river is where he was located.
How was he located? Was he located by a diver? Was he located by sonar?
The ultimate, yes, a diver did go underneath the water and locate him, but the initial was by utilizing that side scan to find a object that appeared to be similar in nature to a person, and then using divers to, like he said, either confirm or deny. Like I said, in this point, we confirmed and located an individual.
Is it unusual that it was found near where he went in? I mean, the water is moving, so why?
So, close to shore, and it just depends. A lot of times up around shore, you get something called like an eddy where the water actually kind of backwashes back on itself and it creates stagnant water where it's not drawing down. So once you get farther out, in this case into the river channel, that current's going to be a lot stronger. In this case, it was closer to shore where that current wasn't as strong.
And when he was found, did he have that flotation device with him?
I can't confirm that at this point.
You mentioned earlier that people saw him struggling. And that somebody tried to assist him. Were those the people who called? Did they try to help him at first? Is that what you were saying?
It was bystanders on that were walking up here along the top of the levee. They had saw him down struggling, heard him. They went down. Of course, it's not easy to get to the bank from here. So they got down, and by the time they got down to the bank and realized that they didn't have anything long enough to get out to him, there was nothing that they could do. And then that was when they saw him go under, and he never resurfaced after that.
And in a situation like that, it was probably safer for them to make the call to police at that point. When you realize you couldn't get, and they did, yes.
You know, anytime you're around the water like that, it's better to get a trained professional to come in and try to attempt that rescue, so we don't end up with more victims than need be. Yes.
And there's been no reports of any kind of boating accidents or anything upriver?
No reports that we're aware of, no.
Where did he get, where was he first spotted at in the river?
About as far as the initial area?
Yeah.
It was close to the same area.
Okay.
Where he was located.
About how far offshore was he found?
I can't confirm that. I don't know the exact yet because I haven't spoke with him to get those exact distances. I mean, roughly 25, 30 feet offshore.
Wow, what, so close.
What's the process of identifying him? Since you haven't had any missing persons calls or anything like that, what happens next?
Yep, like I said, that's where the coroner gets involved, and they use, you know, what they can, whether it be if he's got identification on him, whether it be an ID or a wallet or something like that, and then confirming through that stuff, as well as, you know, there are different means that the coroner's office can go through to identify that individual.
How deep is that water right in there where you found him?
Oh, one more time, let's have your first lesson from each of you. Tell me how you spell that one more time, because I didn't think I got that the first time.
You're right. So to answer your question real quick, as far as depth goes, it was approximately between 10 and 15 feet in that area. And then, like I said, deeper as you go out.
Yep. How far is the drop-off out there? Where is the drop-off?
Drop-off, I'm not positive on that. Correct.
When I was out walking earlier, when I was in the river, actually walking the river, the drop-off is about 15 feet out, and then it drops to probably at least 10 feet at that point.
Is this an area, just out of curiosity, where people go in and swim?
Names again?
Yeah.
One more time?
Not really.
I didn't think so.
My name is Travis Stewart.
You never know.
Yeah.